I'm reading through. I got certain information. I've the actual chemical agent of that drug is bevacizumab. It's an antibody. When it's antibody, it means it is something that is against certain things in the body. It's an IgG1, as we call it, the chemical. Yes, just like Senator Robini said, when it was initially found, it was for treatment as an antibody to treat cancer, particularly colorectal cancer. What we call cancer is the large intestine. However, as part of the research of that particular chemical content, there was some offline thing. Because the way it works is that it blocks certain what we call vascular endothelial growth factor. That's more technical, but it's about blocking something in the blood. And for that, it was licensed to be used for certain things in the eyes. So we do respect my colleagues. It isn't that the doctors that use it, they were using it for what it's not meant for. It is used to treat certain eye conditions, particularly what we call diabetic retinopathy, which is when diabetes affects the eye. It's used to treat retinal vein occlusion. That's a condition when certain things in the eye, what we call the lens of the eye, when it is blocking. And particularly something we call age-related macular degeneration. It is also used to treat that. So unlike what is stated in the newspaper, that the patient has cataract and so on, no. The doctors in that interview said that the patient do have eye conditions that are treatable, are amenable to that particular thing. Secondly, the doctors also said they have been using it in that particular hospital, because it's a national eye center, to treat such degenerative conditions. Now they said, what happened in this situation? They are finding out. And not like Dr. Ruby there, what could have happened? Maybe the particular batch of the ones they have, or certain adverse reactions that are unexpected happen to those patients. Three, they said some of the patients in that particular paper also have recovered their eyes, that means their eyesight, but some did not. So with all this background, sir, I support the motion that there is a need for further investigation to be able to know what were the actual circumstances in that particular hospital. But it isn't that the drug was not meant for treatment of the condition they were used for. The second thing is that I support their prayer that NAPA to provide us a report. And that is also part of the investigation, because whatever committee we set up, we have to protect both with the treating physicians, the patient, as well as the regulatory body. Of course, it depends on the findings of such committees. They will be able to know, because as health practitioners, some...
The distinguished, you can round up.